Guwahati. So today we will conduct an informal session with our lab mates and interns. So today we have with us, in my extreme right, Swatantri Chakraborty from IIT Guwahati itself, and then to my right, Anshuman from IIT Hyderabad, to my extreme left, Atish from Department of Mechanical Engineering, Jadavpur University, and to my left, Shobhit from the same university, Department of Chemical Engineering. So now I come to Anshuman. He is from IIT Hyderabad. So I would ask him to introduce himself and tell me something about your hobbies.
Hello, I am Anshuman Bashupala. I am originally from Orissa, but I stay in Mumbai since my childhood. And I've been staying in a lot of places lately. Like since my college is in IIT Hyderabad, so now coming to my hobbies and all, my favorite pastime would be like just laying, doing nothing. But when I get creative, I do write some poems and short stories, and that's the time when I feel like I'm myself the most. So yeah, that would be it.
Okay, Anshuman, I'll come back to you. So now I come to Swatantri. Would you kindly introduce yourself?
Well, my name is Swatantri Chakraborty, and I'm from Agartala, Tripura. I completed my BTech from NIT Agartala itself, and then after that I was in a job for a year, which I then left and started to prepare for GATE, and then came here in IIT Guwahati, Chemical Engineering Department. Right now I'm about to finish my M.Tech degree in a few days. Next step, well, I haven't thought about it yet. Let's see what happens. So that's about it. I love my time here, and I love the batchmates plus my lab mates and seniors. It was a good time in IIT Guwahati.
Thank you, Swatantri. So now I come to our interns. They have come here for internship and they are doing their project work with us. Now I come to Atish. Atish, please introduce yourself and tell me something about yourself, about your hobbies and other things.
Okay. My name is Atish Ghosh and I came from Bakura, which is a district of West Bengal. And I am currently doing my BTech from Jadavpur University in Mechanical Engineering Department. And I have come here to do an internship. Future design is assisting me under Dupambar Mandavanta. And my main hobby is like playing video games, and I like love to play FIFA and all the video games like that. And I also read storybooks often.
Thank you, Atish. Now I would like to ask Shomik. The questions are same. Please introduce yourself and tell me something about your hobbies and other things.
Okay. Hi, I'm Shobhik. I'm born and brought up in Calcutta itself. I study in Jadavpur University, Department of Chemical Engineering. My hobbies would be playing football and quizzing. Currently, what I'm doing is I'm spending a lot of time promoting Jadavpur University to the world. And the JU journal is a very big part in that. It helps in doing that. You can follow our page, our Facebook page and our website, the links to which are given in the description of this video. That's pretty much it.
Okay, thank you, Shobhi. So he has interest in quizzing and other things, and he is working to promote Jadavpur University. We'd also like to promote our university, our IIT Guwahati. So I would like to request our viewers to please share this video so that we can promote our channel. And I guess from this video, most of the people, aspirants of JEE, aspirants of JEE mains, the people who are looking for admission
and aspirants of GATE also.
Yeah, and aspirants of GATE also. So the main purpose of making this video is to convey message to all of you. So again, I'm coming back with few questions to all of the participants. So now I would like to ask Swatantri, as you have completed your BTech and almost completed your MTech, you are experienced more than other people present here. So can you tell me how was your BTech in NIT Agartala?
Yeah, well, to begin, I would like to say that NIT Agartala, I mean, when I started doing my BTech in chemical engineering, I was the first batch. So 2009 was the year. So I faced a lot of difficulties, as it is, understandable that I was the first batch. But still, somehow I managed to pull through and also landed a job, which was decent. But then again, I didn't feel that I was successful, or you might say that I was growing in it. I was learning. I didn't feel that I was learning anything from that job, and that's why I decided to quit my job and come back to academics. And that's why I joined IIT Guwahati, and it hasn't proven to be a bad decision yet. Then again, I don't know what the future holds for me. I can only hope for the best, and I would also like to tell the viewers of this video that keep your hopes up and just work hard, and your dreams might just come true one day.
I have one more question to you. As you have completed your BTEC and also did 1 year of job, and after that you are doing your MD. So I would like to ask you, what would you suggest to the aspirants or the people who are doing BTEC now? So doing job after BTEC is better, or pursuing higher study is a good option, or it depends on the individuals, or what other factors may decide the thing?
See, I think it's a combination of all the factors that you mentioned. It kind of depends more on the individual, what he or she feels like. If someone is feeling like to go and be in a job scenario and in the corporate world, then of course go ahead and get your first hand experience. But I would say that our generation is kind of insulated from the real world when they are in college. And when you first go out into the real world, it kind of hits you like a truck. And sometimes it becomes difficult for people to adjust. So, but then again, it will make you a better person. It will make you better at handling people and managing your own tasks. Taking responsibility for your own life. So yeah, go ahead and join a job if you get one. But then again, try different things, because you are kind of young in age and you have options to explore, which maybe our earlier generations didn't have. So go out and explore your options and see what suits you the best. That's the only advice I can give you right now.
Okay, Shobhadru, can you tell me what extra things you have learned during your MTech? Is it more or less like BTech course, or you have learned some extra things that actually would help you in your future life?
Well, even though we had a rigorous coursework here in IITG, but the main thing that I learned here is how to, define a research problem and then conducting experiments. Not just conducting, designing your own experiments. This time around, I learned that you have to come up with your experimental procedures. And what happened in school was you were given a manual and you just had to blindly follow those steps. But in MTech and in further, for doctoral studies, you have to think, you have to sit down and think about your problem and then devise your own experiment. So that is a challenge. And I should be thankful to this lab, microfluidics lab, the chemical engineering department, that I got such great seniors who helped me a lot in understanding the nuances of experimenting and coming up with new ideas, that I feel that someday I will get a PhD and hopefully a good one.
So
that is the most important lesson that I learned in IITG.
Thank you, Shantanu. We all wish that you get a good PhD. Probably you have written GRE also, so I wish you that you get a good PhD.
Yeah.
So something about GRE if you can tell.
Okay, GRE. Well, first of all, GRE is a costly exam, very costly in fact.
Costly in the sense of.
Monetary value, it's quite costly. People are there whose ambition is to, go abroad for studies, and there is nothing wrong in it. You will get the opportunity of your lifetime. The kind of, research exposure you would get is unbelievable there. So if you really want to go, you have to again sit for GRE and TOEFL both. if you're talking about GRE, then GRE's level of English is quite tough.
I'll ask you one question. Some of the people who are not from English medium background, they have come from, say, some state board. So what do you suggest to them in order to clear this GRE examination? Because it's all based on English.
English is the, make or break section according to me. Because Indian students, we are generally very good at maths. So the quant section won't be a problem, but the verbal section would be. So the people who are not really fluent in English, what I would suggest to them is start reading.
get anything like a book, magazine or whatever. Start watching English movies too. And I mean, just whatever you get your hands on, like the Hindu newspaper or the Statesman, you go through their editorial. It will be tough in the beginning because there would be words, but you mark those words, go to the dictionary, keep a dictionary in your mobile. Everybody owns a smartphone today, so use that and look up your words. There are various apps available too, which help in, you know, advancing our vocabulary.
Yeah.
So yeah, so give yourself 3 months time, and I think most of the, you know, people are going to grab GRE. I mean, a decent score. But there is one thing which I also need to mention: get an admission in a foreign university. Don't make the GRE your only focus. GRE is only but a part in the admission process, and you should try to, you know, better your overall profile. That is, I mean, your extracurricular activities plus your research, your projects and everything like that. That would help you more. So even if you get a lesser GRE score, your overall profile can compensate for it.
Okay, thank you, Sadhguru. One last question to you. As probably you appear for AIEEE, nowadays I don't feel that this examination exists. But the thing is, as a last batch of probably the last batch of AIEEE, how was that examination? I mean, I like to ask you the difficulty level of that examination.
Yeah, in our times, AIEEE was only the entrance examination for getting admission into the NITs and a few other colleges, of course. But after that, the government decided to scrap it and introduce the IIT mains and advanced, I think.
One common exam.
One common exam with 2 tiers in it. I think our interns are going to throw better light on that. But if you were talking about AIEEE, then its standards was lesser than IIT, but then again quite difficult. The chemistry portion was easier and people used to score in that section and, I mean, get their overall cutoff. I mean, overall score beyond the cutoff. So, but I cannot throw much light on how the standard of examination is right now. But I hear that it's still quite difficult.
Thank you, Sadhguru. As he has mentioned, we have Anshuman with us. He has cleared this JEE mains and advanced examination. So I would like to ask Anshuman, how do you feel clearing the JEE mains and advanced? What are the things required to achieve this goal actually?
Okay, so regarding that, I would say it is not much difficult to crack any exam given you are decent enough sincere for those exams. I was never a very hard working guy, but the one thing was sure that I used to study every day. So it does not actually matter how much length of the time scale, no one is saying you to study for 6 hours a day, go a coaching class which starts at 5 o'clock and ends at night at 10 o'clock. But if you even try for 3 hours every day, which I used to do, do it every day. And there should not be any gap and something. And you should not play favorites. Like, okay, I like maths a bit, I'm not so good at chemistry, I'm not so good at physics.
So you have to give importance to all the subjects.
Give equal right to all those subjects. Some may be difficult for you depending upon your personal understanding, but give everything a good enough study, because no two exams, you know, as we say, two pillars can't make a chair stand on its own. So you need at least 3 of the subjects to make a base.
So I guess the statements made by Anshuman would obviously help the viewers. And one more thing I would like to ask Anshuman. There is a myth that IIT guys do not enjoy their life, they only do study. So if you kindly say something.
Okay, so
actually I'm talking about IIT BTECs guys.
Yeah. Once you get into an IIT, the pressure comes from 100 to 20. Yeah. On a scale of sincerity. You need not actually study anything once you enter your BTEC life. And since no one takes too much effort, so it would be overall normalized. So you need not worry about those study hours. I would say, suppose for your 11th and 12th year, you used to study 3 hours every day. I think 5 hours a week in your BTEC life would be more than enough to get your 9-pointer or something, which would be a pretty good score. And so most of the guys follow this regime. Me myself was just watching some TV series before this interview, so though I am doing an intern, which will be very specific for 1 month intern, but still I am just enjoying for more like 6 or 7 hours a day. I hardly work sometimes. And
okay, thank you, Anshuman. Anshuman, I have one more question to you. If you kindly tell us something about IIT Hyderabad.
Okay, so IIT Hyderabad was one of the new IITs built in 2008. So it has completed almost 9 to 10 years of its history. So I was the third batch in chemical engineering. My chemical engineering in IIT Hyderabad started from 2011. So it's still a pretty new batch. With the last batch was the strength of 40 students. Mine was a strength of 20 students. So the one thing good about new IITs is like since there are less number of students per class, each student has a kind of personal rapport with every professor. Even the least performing guys would actually be known by professors and would be given special care. Which suppose in some of the other courses which I have attended, like some math courses, in which the strength is almost about 100, you won't get any such personal attention towards the professor and just a routine class. So I would actually prefer those 20 students class over those big IITs any day. And since there are lesser number of students, I think I get more opportunities for proving myself, be it in any platform which I go. I face actually very less competition in entering, so you know, I'll get to know myself much more in a new IIT. Rather than the academics is pretty good and I think it would be at par with any other college which I know. And the research work in IIT Hyderabad is one of the finest in India. So, and we also have very young and dynamic professors in our college. So, I think if you are planning to enter any IIT, this college is one of them.
But you only said about the academics now. Tell about the, I mean, the campus, the extracurricular activities. What do you do for fun in
IIT
Hyderabad?
So, I will take it over to campus life at IIT Guwahati. I am also from IIT Guwahati.
The campus in IIT Hyderabad is at a transient state. Since last 3 years, I used to stay in the temporary campus, which was nothing more than a military shed, we can say. But then, if you see the Google images for the new campus, you would be like awestruck. Or is it some five-star hotel or something, or it's just a boys' hostel? The designs are awesome, though we just have the hostel and an academic building as of now. But the things which are made are like I would say some of the best infrastructures in India as of now. And the future planning is very long. I think it will take around 20-30 years to. For the campus to actually be completed. Regarding the extracurricular activities, you actually have a lot of platforms and every domain would be like short of students because of the lesser strength of people. Like every BTech batch has hardly 200 to 240 students in a batch. So if you compare it to some older IITs like Bombay or something, they would have 1000 students in every batch. So if you see, but we do have the same number of clubs, the same number of fest and other things. So you can see like each guy can participate in more than 2 or 3 events if he wants to. So regarding that, I think it's a very good part.
Okay, Owen Shoshumar, the last question to you. As you are a BTech student, but still you have some interest in research. So what would you like to do after completing your BTech?
After completing my BTech, I was aiming for a direct PhD. It doesn't matter if it's in India or in abroad. If it's a good college, I would obviously go for it. As of now, I aspire to become a professor in one of the IITs. My soul to do that is good. But like, I am much interested in research because I every subject that is thrown upon me, I like to explore it more. If I like it, then I go deep enough to ask, challenge any professor on that subject. So that was one of the thing I had since I was a child, and since I was a kid. So that thing actually grew over the years, and I don't think I would be compatible for any job or something, because I don't feel myself suited for a 9-to-5. So I always just think for research.
Thank you.